Hey everyone, and welcome to this review note. In this clip, we're going to explore getting endpoints connected into our network a little bit faster, so we don't have to wait for the spanning tree algorithm to run when we connect in a device. I've added a PC into my network. I haven't connected it yet. I'm going to do that now. So what we're going to do is connect in our PC, and we're going to time how long it takes for that interface to become active. And all the switches are configured for rapid spanning tree. So it's as quick as we're going to get unless we actually disable that on a port. So I'm going to pick Fast Ethernet 1 to connect this in, and we'll just time and see how long it takes for that port to come up. Okay, so that was about 7 seconds, and we can see that the port is now active. Now what I'm going to do is disconnect this guy by getting rid of the cable. And then I'm going to go into my desktop switch. We can see the messages that came through for the port going up and down. And I'm going to go into global config and then config mode for FA01, which is where I'm going to connect in. And once I'm in there, we'll see that we've got a spanning tree command that we can work with. And if I look at my options, one of the things I can do is enable Portfast, and that's what I'm going to do here. So Portfast is now enabled. It says it will only work if the interface is non-trunking mode, and I put the interface into access mode, so we don't have a problem with that. Also notice that there's a caution here. If a BPDU shows up on a Fast Ethernet, what will happen is that is the switch that you connect in is going to automatically, immediately be enabled, and it's not going to have time for spanning tree to run. The problem that we have with that is if for some reason or another you have created a loop, then that loop is going to cause all sorts of problems because you're going to end up with a broadcast storm. Notice that in addition to setting port fast, there's also this thing called BPDU guard, and we can enable that so that if somebody plugs a switch into a port that's not supposed to be seeing a switch, as soon as a BPDU frame shows up on that interface, interface itself is going to be disabled. Now, I haven't done that, so I'm not going to worry about it, but in production, if you configure ports for Portfast, you should also configure the ports with BPDU guard. Now, I've got that configured. We're ready to go. I'm going to pop back out here, and again, I'm going to set up my connection, and we'll watch and see how quickly now when I connect on to the switch that port becomes active. So I'll just click that, and we can see that the interface is immediately alive. So it did not go through the spanning tree process to see if some other switch showed up on that port. So it wasn't sending out BPDUs and saying, hey, is there a switch out there somewhere I need to talk to? This is what we normally would do when we're connecting endpoints so that we don't have people hooking up PCs or printers and wondering, hey, what's going on? Why isn't this talking on the network? So, wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.